Hi, I'm Melissa Niesen with Emerson. I am a research engineer with Fisher Valves, and I focus on flow sciences. Today we're going to see a demonstration of cavitation. Normally you can't see the cavitation within your pipeline, but here we have a very special setup so that we can actually visualize the cavitation that a lot of our customers might encounter in their processes. So what we have here is a 2-inch flow line. We have an inlet valve that's going to control our inlet pressure. This is our test valve, and it's a rotary valve installed backwards, a ball valve. And we're using this valve installed the way it is so that we can create a severe cavitation very easily. And then down on this end, we have our outlet valve, and that we can use to supply back pressure to the system. First off, we're going to show you just some basic turbulent flow noise. Next off, we're going to get a little bit more exciting and up the pressure drop across the valve a little bit higher. And what you'll see is the noise is going to increase, and then you'll see the cavitation region moving into the pipe. And as I adjust that inlet pressure higher and higher, you'll see the region of cavitation moving further down the pipe. And what that's telling us is that the vena contracta in the valve is getting lower and lower pressure, and the region of pressure recovery is taking longer in the pipe to recover from that pressure drop. And if you pay attention to this pressure meter right here, you'll see the arrows start going down. And that means we're pulling a vacuum at the vena contracta. So even though we'll be at several PSI inlet, we'll be pulling a vacuum at the vena contracta. So the level of cavitation, vibration, and noise can get pretty high. As you notice, as the inlet pressure got higher and higher, the vibration and the noise got louder and louder. And if this were in a steel pipeline, we would expect damage to occur after a while in that pipeline. So one of the things that we'd like to show you here is a little bit about things you can do to mitigate that cavitation damage or that cavitation that occurs. One thing we can do is called aspiration, and that's injection of a compressible fluid into the vena contracta downstream of the valve. And I'll show you that in just a minute, but what you'll see is that since we're pulling a vacuum right here, right downstream of the valve, I'll be able to open up this valve and the vacuum will pull in extra air into the line, and that air will combine with the cavitation first to cushion the implosion of those cavitation bubbles and also to mitigate some of that noise that is developed because of the cavitation. So you'll hear that there'll be a lot less damage and a lot less noise that would occur in that case. Of course, a lot of applications can't handle a compressible fluid injected into their process fluid. It just so happens that this line is emptying into a sump, so extra air doesn't matter much. And that's something that we use here in the flow lab frequently in our actual day-to-day testing. Probably a more useful way to eliminate or mitigate cavitation is to apply back pressure. And that's what we're going to look at next. We'll show you some cavitation happening, and then I'm going to close off this rear valve a little bit, and you'll be able to see the cavitation lessening, and it might even go away. We'll see.